इन स्क्वायर मीटर. नाउ इंटीग्रेशन. प्लानीमीटर मैथमेटिकली इंस्ट्रूमेंट फॉर डायरेक्टली मेजरिंग द एरिया बाय एन इरेगुलर कर्व एंड हेंस द वैल्यू ऑफ अ डिफाइनाइट इंटीग्रल. कैलकुलेशन एरिया ऑफ इंडिकेटर डायग्राम. मेक अ स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ऑन द एक्सपांशन लाइन. बिगिन ट्रेसिंग फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एंड सम सर्कमस्क्राइब द डायग्राम एट इवन स्पीड एंड नॉट टू स्लोली. एम्प्लॉय गुड इल्यूमिनेशन एंड इफ नेसेसरी यूज अ मैग्नीफाइंग ग्लास फॉर एक्यूरेट रीडिंग ऑफ द वर्नियर बिफोर एंड आफ्टर सर्कमस्क्रिप्शन. The difference in readings is proportional to the area of the indicator diagram. Next. Advantages of linear and polar planimeter compared to hedge planimeter. Linear and polar planimeters give exact values not only in approximations. Hedge planimeters should not be used for very large or very small areas. In the first case, the approximation of the circle by a line gives large error. In the second case, there is small displacement between initial and final position. Thank you everyone for listening our presentation. We hope that you understand our presentation. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Okay. Wait for the 2 minutes. I will join soon. Okay, I have an important call.
Okay.
Hello. Okay. Sorry. There was some important call from our department. Okay. So the topic is planimeter. Okay, from the group number is 20. So each every component is discussed and the formula is also discussed. What is the value of initial reading, final reading, then the constant of M and C. Okay, during the lecture or practical, you also study this topic, planimeter. But I hope that your doubts and any problem asked question may be solved here. Okay, what is the value of C, M, and how we decide that we discuss here and the various component. Okay, I think a lot more cover in this present session compared to in a regular classes. So it is a very good presentation, and the all details are covered basically with the application. So very nice presentation. Okay, so next group, I think one student needs to be requesting for the group number 22. Okay, so we take group number 22 presentation first. So ID number
21.
Yes, sir, 21. Next. Don't worry. Okay, who is the presenter? From the
okay, sir.
21
it is. Okay. Okay, now you can share a presentation. You can start.
Hello sir, is it visible?
Yes.
Before I start, I would like to say that it takes 4 years for a human to become an engineer, and then even a lifetime cannot make him a human again. Hello everybody, good afternoon. First of all, thank you for giving me this opportunity to introduce myself. My name is Raj Jani and ID number 21. My group members are Vijay, Jinil, Pintu and Vishal. Today the topic of our presentation is all about Guntur. This topic is provided us by Professor Dhaval Parmar. He is the assistant professor of civil engineering, and guidance given by him also. Professor I.B. Jala is also given us to guidance. Now, we are going to talk about Guntur. Our content is Guntur, first of Guntur, second Guntur map, Gunturing, use of Guntur map, purpose of Gunturing, Guntur interval, factor on which Guntur interval depends, common values of Guntur interval, horizontal equivalent, characteristics of Guntur, method of Guntur, and references. Now, looking further, I would like to go on Guntur. What is Guntur? Guntur is an imaginary line on the ground surface joining the points of equal elevation is known as Guntur. Here, equal elevation means same height. In other words, Guntur is a line in which the ground surface is intersected by a level surface obtained by joining points of equal elevation. This line on the map represents a contour and is called a contour line. Here, next slide is a contour map. What is contour map? Contour map is a map which shows a contour line. A map is showing contour lines is known as contour map. A contour map gives an idea of the altitudes of the surface features as well as their relative position. In plan serves the purpose of both a planned and section. Here I have a video of contour map. Please show the video. There are no voice, please watch. thanks for watching the video. Now I would like to go to further. धारो के कॉन्टूर मैप सर्वे कॉन्टूर सर्वे करवानो होय तो आ एक ढोळावाळी जमीन छे अने आया ऊपर पर्वतो टेकरा नाना आवेला छे। आपणे कॉन्टूर सर्वे करवा माटे जुदा जुदा पॉइंट लईने अहीं आरएल मापवानो, सी लेवल थी आरएल मापवानो। हियर इज आरएल 90 डिग्री, हियर इज 100, हियर इज 110, 90, 100, 100, these are the same points of same heights. Contour is a closed circle line. Contour line is a so closed circle line. Here આપણે આ નાના નાના જે 90 વાળા સેમ હાઈટ વાળા જે પોઈન્ટ છે એનાથી એક ક્લોઝ સર્કલ દોરીએ. ધીસ ઇઝ ધ કોન્ટુર લાઈન. હિયર 100 વાળા એક સેમ ઊંચાઈ વાળા પોઈન્ટ લઈને આપણે બધાને જોડીને એક સેમ લાઈન દોરીએ. This is the type of contour map. Now I will go further contouring. The process of tracing contour lines on the surface on the earth is called contouring. Now let's move on to the next topic. Now I would like to hand over further to my friend and group mate Pintu.
Hello everyone, good afternoon. I am Goy Pintu. My ID number is 20C011. I am going to speak about purpose of contouring. Contour survey is carried out at the starting of any engineering project such as road, a railway, a canal, a dam, a building, etc. First purpose is for preparing contour maps in order to select the most economical or suitable site. પહેલો પર્પસ એવું છે કે જ્યારે કન્ટુર મેપ્સ બનાવવા માટે યુઝ પર કન્ટુર મેપ પ્રિપેર કરવા માટે કન્ટુરિંગનું પર્પસ છે. સેકન્ડ, ટુ લોકેટ ધ અલાઇનમેન્ટ ઓફ અ કેનલ સો ડેટ ઇટ શુડ ફોલો અ રીજ લાઇન. થર્ડ, ટુ માર્ક ધ અલાઇનમેન્ટ ઓફ રોડ્સ એન્ડ રેલવે સો ડેટ ધ ક્વોન્ટિટી ઓફ અર્થ વર્ક બોથ ઇન કટિંગ એન્ડ ફિલિંગ શુડ બી મિનિમમ. ફોર્થ, for getting information about the ground whether it is flat, undulating or mountainous. Fifth, to find the capacity of a reservoir and the volume of the earthwork especially in mountainous region. કોઈ પણ માઉન્ટેનિયસ રીજનમાં આર્ટિફિશિયલ લેક અથવા નેચરલ લેકનું વોલ્યુમ ચેક કરવા માટે એની કેપેસિટી જોવા માટે આનો કન્ટુરિંગનો પર્પઝ છે. Now, sixth, to trace out the given grade of a particular route. And last, to locate the physical features of the ground, such as pond, depression, hill, steep or small slopes. એટલે કે ગ્રાઉન્ડનો કોઈ પણ ફિઝિકલ ફીચર્સને લોકેટ કરવા માટે, જેમ કે પોન્ડ છે, હિલ છે, હિલ સ્ટીપ છે કાં તો સ્મોલ સ્લોપ છે. નાવ આઈ ફર્ધર હેન્ડ ઓવર ધીસ ટુ વિશાલ, માય ગ્રુપ મેટ.
Hello everybody, first of all thank you for giving me this opportunity. To introduction to myself, my name is Vishal Rathwa and my ID number is VCE081. Now I am going to talk about use of contour map. To select sites for engineering projects such as roads, canals, railways, means ke rastao, canal or railway jeva engineering project mate sites પસંદ કરવા માટે આ મેપનો બહુ ઉપયોગ થાય છે. એન્ડ સેકન્ડ, ટુ ફાઇન્ડ ધ પોસિબલ રૂટ ઓફ કોમ્યુનિકેશન બિટવીન ડિફરન્ટ પ્લેસ, તો કે ડિફરન્ટ સ્થળો વચ્ચે સંભવિત માર્ગ શોધવા માટે પણ આનો ઉપયોગ બહુ થાય છે. થર્ડ, ધ કે
Hello. Hello, dear, you are not. Is there any network issue?
Sir, there is issue some. Yes, sir.
What up?
Sir, there is some issue from each side.
Okay, next student can start when he joined. He gives that.
Sir, 1 minute. I will text him.
Sir, I think he can't join. So further we
next
member.
Next student, you can start. Who is next?
Senior, now you can start your presentation and go ahead with your topic.
Next page. Next. Okay. Hello everyone. Good afternoon. My name is Jinil. My ID number is VC036. My topic is contour interval. Yeah, now I am start. The contour vertical distance between a two colligative contour is called to contour interval. Satat be roop rekha vache satat vertical antar ne contour interval kahevama aave chhe. Contour interval for flat ground are generally small. Example 0.25 meter, 0.5 meter, 0.75 meter. Flat ground matena contour interval samany rite nanla hoy chhe. Example 0.25 meter, 0.5 meter, 0.75 meter. The contour interval for step slope in a hill area in generally example 5 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter. डुंगराळ विस्तारमां सीधा ढाळ માટેના કન્ટુર ઇન્ટરવલ સામાન્ય રીતે વધારે હોય છે એક્ઝામ્પલ 5 મીટર 10 મીટર એન્ડ 15 મીટર અગેન ફોર અ સ્મોલ સ્કેલ મેપ ધ ઇન્ટરવલ મે બી ફોર 1 મીટર 2 મીટર ઓર 3 મીટર ફરીથી નાના પાયા નકશા માટે ઇન્ટરવલ એમ 2 મીટર 3 મીટર વગેરે હોઈ શકે કન્ટુર ઇન્ટરવલ ઇઝ કીપ લાર્જ up to 2 meter for project such a highway railway rest is kept as a small 0.5 meter of measurement of earthquake building sites dams highway and railway jeva project mate contour interval 2 meter sudhi mota rakhvama aave chhe jyare te dhartikamp makan sthalo demo vagere na mapan mate 0.5 meter jetlu nanu rakhvama aave chhe it is a desirable to have a constant contour interval for a vertical map કોઈ ચોક્કસ નકશા માટે સતત કન્ટુર ઇન્ટરવલ રાખવા ઈચ્છનીય છે affects on which contour interval depends. The nature of the ground in the flat, uniformly sloping country, the contour interval is small, but in broken and mountain region, the color interval should be large. Otherwise, the contour will come too close to earth other. ग्राउंड ने प्रकृति सपाट अने एक सरखा ढाल वाला देश में कंटूर इंटरवल ओछा हुई छे, परंतु तूटेली अने पर्वतीय प्रदेश में समोच्च अंतर मोटा होवा जोईए नहीं, तो रूपरेखा एक बीजा ने खूब नजीक आवे छे. सेकंड, द पर्पस एंड एक्सटेंट ऑफ द सर्वे. कंटूर इंटरवल इज स्मॉल इफ द एरिया टू बी सर्वे इन द स्मॉल एंड मैप आर रिक्वायर्ड to be used for the designing work or of determine the question test of the earth and while the wider interval shall have to be kept for the large area and comparatively less important works. Correction na hetu ana had contour interval ochu che. જો સર્વેક્ષણ કરવાનો વિસ્તાર નાનો હોય અને ડિઝાઇન માટે અથવા પૃથ્વી કાર્યના માત્ર નક્કી કરવા માટે નકશાનો ઉપયોગ કરવો જોઈએ. જ્યારે મોટા ઇન્ટરવલો અને તુલનાત્મક રીતે ઓછા મહત્વ કામો માટે વિશાળ ઇન્ટરવલ રાખવો પડશે. આપણે જે જમીન પર જે કોઈ કામ કરવાનું હોય, ધારો કે કોઈ બિલ્ડિંગ ને સ્ટ્રક્ચર બનાવવાનું હોય, તેના માટે પેલા આપણે કામ કરીએ, પુરાને કામ કરીએ ને તે સર.
મતલબ શું? Transcript to the correct, no doubt. But what you can understand. Okay.
E important. આપણે પહેલા સ્ટ્રક્ચર બનાવીએ તેના પહેલા જે પાણ કરીએ છીએ.
ઓકામ કરીએ છીએ ને આપણે.
હા.
ઠીક છે.
હા, યસ.
વર્ક કોડ આ બોલો. જે પૃથ્વી કામ છે એનો મતલબ ખોદકામ જે કર્યું, તમે કટિંગ એન્ડ ફિલિંગ, ધેટ વોટ વી નીડ ટુ યુઝ. ઓકે, ડિટરમાઇન ધ ક્વોન્ટિટી ઓફ અર્થવર્ક, એનો મતલબ શું? કે બિફોર ધ કન્સ્ટ્રક્શન યુ નીડ ટુ ઇન્વેસ્ટિગેટ સોઇલ, તમે ઇન્વેસ્ટિગેટ કરો. ઓકે, તે અર્થવર્ક મીન્સ કે એસ્કેવેશન, જે માટીનું ખોદકામ તમે કરો છો ને એને કહેવાય અર્થવર્ક. મતલબ કે તમે બોલાય પૃથ્વી કાર્ય. ઓકે, ગુજરાતીમાં ટ્રાન્સલેટ કરો, આઈ ડોન્ટ complain about it. Okay, it is very good, but also you need to understand the meaning of that word. Okay, finally, why we translate? To understand each and every term in our own language. Okay, so generally tumhe translate karo jo, I am happy ke tumhe translate karo jo, ena mate mehnat karo jo, dictionary ke
next page.
Okay, when you translate the word, please understand properly. Okay, the quantity of earthwork means ne tumhe gujarati mein translate karo, but also tumhare ene samajhvanu chhe. Okay,
yes sir.
Yes, very good. Okay, next line.
Next page. Okay, the scale of the map, the contour intervals should be in the interval ratio to the scale of the map. The small the scale, the generate is contour interval. નકશાનો સ્કેલ કંટ્રોલ ઇન્ટરવલ ઉલટા ગુણોત્તર હોવા જોઈએ, એટલે કે જેટલું નાનું સ્કેલ તે કંટ્રોલ ઇન્ટરવલ વધારે. ફોર, ટાઈમ એન્ડ એક્સપેન્સ ઓફ ફાઇલ્ડ ઓફિસ વર્ક. ધ સ્મોલર ધ ઇન્ટરવલ, ધ જનરેટ ઇઝ ધ એમાઉન્ટ ઓફ ફાઇલ્ડ વર્ક એન્ડ floating work. क्षेत्र अने ऑफिस फील्ड्सना कार्यनो समय अने खर्च इंटरवल जेटलू ओछू छे। ते क्षेत्र कार्य अने कावतरू कार्यनी मात्रा वधारे छे। नेक्स्ट कॉमन वेल्यू ऑफ द कंटूर इंटरवल। फर्स्ट फॉर लार्ज स्केल मे ऑफ फ्लैट कंट्री ऑफ बिल्डिंग साइट्स फॉर डिटेल डिजाइन वर्क एंड फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ क्वांटिटी ऑफ अर्थ वर्क 0.5 to 0.5 meter। फ्लैट देश ना मोटा पाया नक्शा माटे बिल्डिंग साइट्स माटे વિગતવાર ડિઝાઇન કાર્ય માટે અને પૃથ્વીના કાર્યની માત્રાની ગણતરી કરવા માટે 0.2 to 0.5 meter। સેકન્ડ ફોર રિઝર્વેશન ટુ ટ્વિન પ્લેટિંગ સિમ્સ 0.5 to 2 meter। જળાશય અને નગર આયોજન યોજનાઓ માટે 0.5 to 2 meter। થર્ડ ફોર લોકેશન સર્વેસ 2 to 3 meter। સ્થાન સંરક્ષણ માટે 2 to 3 meter। ફોર સ્મોલ્સ ઓફ બ્રોકન કન્ટ્રી એન્ડ જનરલી ટોપોગ્રાફી વર્ક 3 meter, 5 meter, 10 meter or 25 meter। તૂટેલા દેશના નાના પાયે નકશા માટે સામાન્ય ટોપોગ્રાફી કાર્ય માટે 3 to 5 meter, 10 meter or 25 meter। નાઉ let's move on the next topic. Now I would like to have a further to my group mate Vijay
sir. Wala 81 number ne net issue hoto ne te wifi karin free zone thyo chhe to te tenu presentation aapi de
pela.
Okay, sorry sir, net issue
81 number ha sir, ene screen share karvanu pan allow aapjo. As you now can stop your screen.
So screen share 81 screen share થઈ સર. Now I am going to talk about use of contour map. Sir, my screen is visible. Hello sir. To select sites for engineering projects such as roads, canal, railways. Okay, rastao, canal, railways.
Screen na the.
Yes, now it is. Okay, now start a project with the purpose of contouring.
Sir, thank you.
Okay,
now screen is visible.
Yes, open it, sir.
Okay, so sir, now I am going to talk about use of contour map. So to select sites for engineering projects such as roads, canals, railways, means ke rastao, canal or railway jeva engineering project hoy che, ani mate sites pasand karva mate a map bahu upyogi thai che. And second, to find the possible route of communication between different place, means કે ડિફરન્સ સ્થળો વચ્ચે સંભવિત માર્ગો શોધવા માટે પણ અમે બહુ ઉપયોગી થાય છે. થર્ડ, ધ કેપેસિટી ઓફ અ રિઝર્વિયર એન્ડ ધ એરિયા ઓફ સબમેરજિનન્સ કેન બી કમ્પ્યુટ, એટલે કે તળાવ સરોવર જેવા જળાશયોની કેપેસિટી અને ડૂબવાના ક્ષેત્રની ગણતરી પણ કરી શકાય છે. તો ફોર્થ એ ટુ એસર્ટેન ધ ઇન્ડિવિઝિબિલિટી ઓફ સ્ટેશન, તો કે સ્ટેશનોની અવિભિજ્યતાની ખાતરી કરવા માટે પણ ઉપયોગ થાય છે. 5 ટુ એસર્ટેન ધ પ્રોફાઇલ ઓફ ધ ગ્રાઉન્ડ સરફેસ અલોંગ એની ડાયરેક્શન, તો કોઈ પણ દિશા સાથે જમીનની સપાટીની પ્રોફાઇલની ખાતરી કરવા માટે.
Okay, Okay, continue. You continue.
A suitable route for giving a gradient giving gradient can be marked on the map. तो के आपल ढोड़ा ढाड़ एवं है एना माटे योग्य मार्क नक्शा पर चिन्हित कर सकाय छे. Seven is to estimate the quantity of cutting filling etc. तो के कापवा भरवा वगैरह जो जत्थानो अंदाज काढ़वा माटे आ कंटूर मैप नो उपयोग थाय छे. तो लास्ट है to know the drainage characteristics of the area. It help to select sites for culverts, bridges, drainage system. Next topic, horizontal equivalent. The horizontal distance between any two adjacent contour is called as horizontal equivalent. The contour interval is constant between the consecutive contour, while the horizontal equivalent is variable and depend upon the slope of the ground. Third, it is not constant, it variable for point to point, depend upon the steepness of the ground. And steeper the ground, lesser in the horizontal equivalent. Now I let's move on the next topic. I would like to my group mate Vijay.
Sir, mun screen karva mate aapjo. Hello sir. हाँ सर, मारा व्हाइट बोर्ड में यूज करवो सर. नाउ इट विजिबल सर.
यस.
Hello everyone, I am Vijay Chauhan. Now I talk to about characteristic of what, sir?
Presentation.
Okay. So my topic is a characteristic of a contour. In a just a few moment of before you learn about characteristic, what is the use of contour and what is the basic of contour. So now I want to talk about characteristic of contour. So first of all, first one is a
presentation mode. Open presentation mode. Open in a presentation mode. Okay, there is
फोन रोटेट कर.
Thank you. So first point is all point is a contour line have the same elevation. So what is the meaning of this sentence? So let's move. જ્યારે આનો મિનિંગ શું કે બધા પોઈન્ટ એક લાઈન ઉપર એલિવેશન હોય, એટલે કે જ્યારે આપણે કોઈ કંટ્રોલ બનાવીએ ત્યારે કંટ્રોલનો ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ તો મિનિંગ કે રાજા કીધો કે જે રીતના આપણે કોઈ ટેકરી હોય આ રીતે એના ઉપર જ્યારે કોઈ સર્વે કરતા હોય અથવા લેવલિંગ કરતા હોય ત્યારે આપણે તેનો આરએલ લઈ લઈએ અને ત્યારે જેનું આરએલ માપીએ ત્યારે આપણને કંટ્રોલ લાઇન બને છે આ રીતના. એવી જ રીતે જો આપણે કોઈ ધારો કે મેં આ કંટ્રોલ લાઇન લીધી એના ઉપર તો જે હું અહીંયા કોઈ બી પોઈન્ટ કોઈ પણ જગ્યાએ કંટ્રોલ લાઇન ઉપર કોઈ બી પોઈન્ટ લઉં તો તેના ઉપરનો આરએલ સેમ હોય એ પોઈન્ટ એ કહેવા માંગતો હતો. હવે નેક્સ્ટ પોઈન્ટ ઉપર
with Angel Broking. Open an account in just 5 minutes and enjoy lifetime free equity delivery.
સર ઉભી જ બોલી રહ્યા કારણ કે તમારે છે ને પ્રોબ્લેમ થાય છે પાછો. Flat ground is an inclined where the contour are widely separate and step slope where they run close together. Means કે જ્યારે આપણે કોઈ ભી ફ્લેટ ગ્રાઉન્ડ હોય અને એક સરખી સપાટી હોય ત્યાં કંટ્રોલ લાઇન લાંબા ગાળાએ હોય અને સ્ટેપ સ્લોપ રીતના હોય. જેમ કે આપણે લઈએ જો આ કોઈ તમે 4D માં ઇમેજિન કરો કે જ્યારે તમે કોઈ હાવ સપાટી રીતના હોય ને ત્યારે આ કોઈ સપાટી હાવ સમતલ છે અને સપાટી ઉપર જ્યારે તમે એનું આરએલ લેશો તો અહીંયા આ પોઈન્ટ ઉપર લ્યો અહીંયા લ્યો કે અહીંયા લ્યો ત્યારે બધા પર સરખો જ આવવાનો. એટલે જ્યારે લાંબા ગાળાની સપાટી તમે લેવામાં આવે તો તેના ઉપરના આરએલની વેલ્યુ બધે સરખી હોય અને એ લાંબા ગાળે એની કંટ્રોલ લાઇન મેપ મળે. ધારો કે જો આ કોઈ ટેકરી છે એના અને કોઈ એની પડખે આ બીજી ટેકરી છે આ રીતના તો એના ઉપર જ્યારે આરએલ લેવામાં આવે તો અહીંયા ને અહીંયા ધારો કે બંને સરખું મળ્યું તો એક સરફેસ સપાટી શેપ થઈ ગયો તો એના ઉપરની આરએલ ની વેલ્યુ સરખી હશે.
Open an account in just 5 minutes and enjoy lifetime free equity delivery.
Third, uniform slope is inclined when the contour line are based in the એટલે કે જ્યારે કોઈ સ્લોપ આપણે ડીવાય બાય ડીએક્સ લઈએ કોઈ જ્યારે ટેકરી હોય એનો ઢાળ લઈએ તો જો એ સરખો હોય તો એનો કંટ્રોલ લાઈનનો પણ ઢાળ સરખો જ આવવાનો એ રીતના. Fourth, plane surface when they are straight parallel and equal space એટલે કે ત્યારે જ્યારે સરફેસ પણ જેવું આપણને સરફેસ મળશે એવું જ આપણું કંટ્રોલ લાઈન ઉપર હશે. પાંચમું, સિરીઝ ઓફ ક્લોઝ કંટ્રોલ લાઈન ઓન ધ મેપ પ્રેઝન્ટ અ હિલ એટલે કે જો તમે અહીંયા આ હિલ આવી રીતના કોઈ હિલ છે અને એના ઉપર તમે આરએલ લીધા છે તો જ્યારે જે એનો ટોપનો ભાગ છે ત્યારે જ તે હિલ કહેવાશે. એટલે તમે જેમ અંદર જતા જશો આ ફોટામાં જુઓ તો એની એ જગ્યાએ આરએલની વેલ્યુ ઘટતી જાય છે વધતી જાય છે એટલે એ રીતના હિલ બનાવશે. હવે જો એને ઓપોઝિટ કરીએ અને આ હિલને આ પેરેગ્રાફને સહેજ ઉલટાવી દઈએ અને તો એના પર ડિપ્રેશન આપે એટલે કે જે આમ આ જે આપણે વેલી હોય એ રીતના ઢાળવાળું થઈ જાય તો જ્યારે તેની તમે જોશો તો અહીંયા આરએલની વેલ્યુ ઘટતી જાય છે તો એ શેના કારણે તો એ જે આપણને જેનો કંટ્રોલ મળશે એ એની અંદરની જે વેલ્યુ છે એ ઓછી હશે. અને આ એક મહત્વનો મુદ્દો જ્યારે આપણે કોઈ બી કંટ્રોલ મેપ બનાવતા હોય ત્યારે આપણી જે કંટ્રોલ લાઈન હોય હંમેશા એક લૂપ બનાવે છે ક્યારે એકબીજાને છેદતી નથી. જેમ કે આ કોઈ કંટ્રોલ લાઈન મેપ બનાવ્યો ત્યારે આ કંટ્રોલ લાઈન કંટ્રોલની લૂપ છે અને જ્યારે કોઈ બીજી કંટ્રોલ હું બનાવી ત્યારે તેના ઉપર આ રીતના ક્યારેય નહીં થાય. આ રોંગ મેથડ છે.
With Angel Broking,
Open an account in just 5 minutes and enjoy lifetime free equity delivery trick.
હવે નેક્સ્ટ પોઈન્ટ પર જઈએ તો જે મેં પોઈન્ટ કીધો એનું ઉલ્લંઘન થતું હોય એવું તમને અહીંયા લાગશે તો કે કંટ્રોલ લાઇન કાઇન્ડ માર્જ ઓર ક્રોસ વન અનધર ઓન મેપ એક્સેપ્ટ ઇન કેચ ઓફ ઓવરહિજ ક્લિપ કે જ્યારે ઓવરહિજ ક્લિપ રીતના હોય તો કઈ રીતના થાય તો કે જો અહીંયા આવી કોઈ આવો કોઈ શેપની કોઈ ટેકરી હોય ત્યારે કદાચ તેના પર આપણને એમ લાગે કે અહીંયા શેપ છે હું બોર્ડ ઉપર લઈ જાઉં તો ધારો કે આ કોઈ હિલ છે અહીંથી જો હું આનું ટોપ વ્યુ મેળવવું હોય મારે કંટ્રોલ લાઇન કરતી વખતે તો કંઈક અહીંયા જે આરએલ હશે જે હું આરએલ લઈશ અને જે કંટ્રોલ લાઇન બનાવીશ એના બધા આરએલ તો અહીંયા જ મળવાના છે અહીંયા ધારો કે આનો આરએલ 100 આ 90 આ 80 તો જે હું જે કંટ્રોલ લાઇન બનાવી આ રીતના બનશે અહીંયા કોઈક પોઈન્ટ ઉપરથી આ રીતના તો ત્યાં તો આપણને એવું લાગે કે આ જે મેં પોઈન્ટ કીધો એનું તો ઉલ્લંઘન થતું હોય એવું પણ એવું નથી જસ્ટ તમારે ઇમેજિન કરવાનું છે કે જો આપણો રેફરન્સ પોઈન્ટ જે લીધો એ બદલાઈ જાય તો આ પોઈન્ટનું ઉલ્લંઘન ન થઈ શકે ખાલી એના ઉપર ઓવરલેપિંગ થયેલી છે એને ચેતતી નથી
Open an account in just 5 minutes and enjoy lifetime free equity delivery trick.
અને લાસ્ટ વન જ્યારે આવી ચાસી બધી જે હિલો ભેગી થાય જે કોઈ પોઈન્ટ જે પોઈન્ટ બનાવે એને સેડલ કહેવામાં આવે છે જેમ કે મેં કોઈ જ્યારે હું સર્વિંગ કરતો અને ત્યારે મેં જુદી જુદી જગ્યાએ લી કંટ્રોલ મેપ બનાવ્યો હોય ત્યારે ધારો કે અહીંથી કોઈ એલીથી આ પોઈન્ટ બીનો આ રીતના આ બધી કંટ્રોલ લાઇન છે જો આવો શેપ બને ને તો એને સેડલ કહેવામાં આવે છે
With Angel Broking, open an account in just 5 minutes and enjoy lifetime equity delivery.
અને એના કન્ટ્રોલિંગ બનાવવા માટેની ટોટલ બે મેથડ ડાયરેક્ટ મેથડ અને ઇનડાયરેક્ટ મેથડ અને અમે બનાવ્યો ત્યારે અમે બીએસ પૂનમિયા સર અને કુલકર્ણી સરની રેફરન્સ બુકમાં એનો રેફરન્સ લીધેલો છે તો થેન્ક્સ ફોર લિસનિંગ મી એન્ડ અવર ટીમ એન્ડ એટ ધ પોઈન્ટ ઓફ સેશન આઈ વુડ ટુ સ્પેશિયલ થેન્ક ધવલ સર હુ અરેન્જ ધીસ ટાઈપ ઓફ સેશન એન્ડ ધે ગાઈડન્સ આઈ નો ધીસ ટાઈપ લેક્ચર help in our future in we all are going to the any company and join create one project so this session will be improve our communication skill and learn to how to our how do teamwork with our team so thank you sir this is now we end our session
Okay. So very good. I think contouring is completely covered in this presentation, starting with the introduction, then the method we use, and the characteristics of the contouring, the applications, the contouring the uses, how we use contouring in a real life for the surveying purpose, for the topography map preparation. So to help you to understand how contouring is helpful, you then by also the uses of a whiteboard is also nice. Yes, very good. Also, the innovative idea to explain the points, it's good. Okay, so all of you learn a new thing in a different way. Okay, how we explain or how we increase our knowledge from the online study. That is the also important part of our life nowadays, because 2 days, 2 years, or two, not 2 days, 2 years are very not as we want, because due to pandemic condition, we are continuously conduct a lecture on our online platform, MS Teams. So it's a good use of an online platform like a whiteboard. So all of you learn a new thing on their own way. So it's a very good, like our one student create a 3D model. Now these students use the whiteboard. So it's very good. Okay. So keep these things and learn new things. This pandemic time. So presentation is very good. And also is very useful for you to understand the each point of a contouring. So very good. Okay. Now next group, group number 21. And the
yes. Yes, sir.
35, 33, 29, 12, and 003. Who is the presenter?
Yes, sir.
12 number. Sir, 12 number. 12. Okay. Okay, now we can share your screen. Start.
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, yes, clear.
Good afternoon, sir. We are here to present on one of the mass transportation system, Metro. So basically, Metro is an underground system, underground railway system in a city. So let me introduce our group members. Kushal Khaped, 20C003. Rohit Gojia, 20C012. Brijat C. Jadeja, 20C029. Tarang Pokal, 20C033. Soumya Patel, 20C035. And it is guided by our professor Dhaval Parmar, sir. So let us begin the presentation. Over it to Rohit.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Rohit Gojia. I will. What is the definition of metro? Metro is a type of rail-based rapid transit or mass rapid transit system, which is also known as heavy rail, MRT, subway tube, or underground rail, is a type of high-capacity public transport system normally found in large cities. Metro is a type of high-capacity public transport generally found in urban areas. Unlike buses or trams, rapid transit systems are electric railways that operate on an exclusive right-of-way, which cannot be accessed by pedestrians or other vehicles of any sort, and which is often grade separated in time tunnels or on elevated railways. Introduction of Metro. How it began? India's first and Asia's fifth metro rail was introduced in Kolkata over a length of 16.45 kilometer, and the world on this project was sanctioned on 1st of June 1972. The construction work started in 1973-74. After crossing so many hurdles, Kolkata Metro started its journey on October 24, 1984. Also, Metro is one of the popular mass transportation systems. Many cities across the world are successfully running Metro. in Gujarat also metro rail network is planned between Ahmedabad to Gandhinagar. Metrolink Express for Gandhinagar and Ahmedabad Company Limited, established by Government of Gujarat on 4th February 2010, is given responsibility for planning and construction of metro. Now I will discuss about vision and mission. Vision: to deliver sustainable solution with superior added economic value for independent entrepreneurs. As a platform, we are working jointly with diverse market players to set tomorrow's standards for absolute customer focus, practice-oriented digital solution, and sustainable business model. Mission: to build a reliable, sustainable, and energy-efficient metro rail network to earn a distinct name in the MRT sector in India and rank among the top metro rail system in the world, to responsibly attend to all citizens with special attention to senior citizens, women, children, and differently abled people. Now Kusal will continue further.
Hello sir, good afternoon. I am Kushal Kapad and my ID number is 20C003. I am going to discuss about purpose, advantages and disadvantages of metro rail system. Purpose: The main purpose of metro is to remove economic welfare loss. There is unprecedented growth of personal vehicles. Because of it, pollution is increasing and it can be reduced by metro rail system. Air pollution and traffic accidents has become a major concern day by day. So it is reduced by metro. Metro is time saving. It reduces fuel consumption to avoid congestion at peak hours. Next, advantages. It is safer, faster, and economical. We can save time by traveling from metro in compared to roadways. It takes less time. It saves us from traffic jams and it is quite safe for every gender. There is no delay in metro because of express trains, and there is no signal problems and no traffic hurdles. It does not cause any type of pollution and it is eco-friendly. Because of AIDS pavement, there is increase in income of metro. Huge revenue is expected if the space used around metro stations is left for commercial business. Journey hours are less in comparison with roadways. Next. Next. Disadvantages: it contains huge space and poor lighting. Poor lighting can affect quality of work, and it is also be health hazard. Too little or too many light may cause eye discomfort. Even if metro goes underground, it needs a lot space on road for construction. Unutilized spaces are paving the way for promotion of antisocial elements, gambling, open bar, dirtying the entire area. Medical facilities are still wanted sector in metro. There is no facilities of restroom in any of metro stations. Now I will hand it over to Tarang.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Tarang Pokal and my ID number is 20C033. Today I am here to give some idea about instruments and tool and equipments for metro. So basically, instrument plays an important role in construction process, not only in metro, but in any of the construction process. So some of the equipments are listed here. First, hydraulic jacks. So hydraulic jack is a lifting device that employs the principle of fluid dynamics. This device generates large amount of lift to raise or lower anything from patient's bed to the large trucks. A hydraulic jack creates a pressure by moving oil through two cylinders via pump plunger. The pump plunger is drawn back, which opens the suction valve and draws oil into the pump chamber. As the plunger is pushed down, the oil is transported through the external discharge valve and into the cylinder chamber. The suction valve then closes, resulting in the pressure being built up within the chamber, causing the chamber causing the piston in the chamber to raise and lift the heavy objects. By repeating this process, we can lift the load higher and higher. Second, hollow ramjack plane ram. It is a sort of hydraulic puller with mechanical accessories which removes and assembles bearing bushes, pins, gears, flanges of machinery, and it is used as pre-stressing jacks at construction sites. Next. Third, flat jacks. Flat jacks are compact and flat design suited where clearance is minimum for insertion of jack. There are two connections, one acting as a vent and it is used to inject pressurized liquid to deploy the jacks over the available stroke. Flat jacks are used as structural weld positioning, rigging in bridge construction and heavy fabrication and maintenance. Fourth, single acting cylinder. It includes two, spring return and spring extend. So basically spring return and spring extend, both of these works in the other way. So in spring return cylinder, the piston rod extends when compressed air is supplied to the cylinder. As the supply is cut off, the piston rod retracts the spring force. But in the spring extend, the piston retracts when the compressed air is supplied. When the air supply is switched off, the spring pushes the rod out. In the spring extend cylinder, the spring is located between the piston and the rear end of the cylinder. Next. Yeah, so here are some tools and equipments for metro rail. First, power driven roller bearing extractor. It is used to dismount roller bearing trunk fitted on the passenger coach axle. A bearing extractor is a tool used to remove bearing sets from a rotating machine shaft or from a blind bearing hole. The most common application is removing a caged set of ball or tapered bearings from the rotating shaft. Second, cartridge taper roller bearing mounting equipments. So tapered roller bearing are commonly used for moderate speed, heavy duty application where durability is required. Tapered roller bearing features tapered inner and outer ring, raceway with the tapered roller arranged between them. This allows the bearing to accept high radial and axial loads from multiple directions. Third, hydraulic power packs for jacks. So hydraulic power pack is a self-contained unit that consists mainly of a motor, a reservoir, and a hydraulic pump. Using fluid to transmit and hydraulic pump of power from one location to another, it generates massive amount of power which can be used to drive hydraulics. So when a heavy lifting or repeated direction force is required, it offers a perfect solution drawing their powers from the ratio of areas and pressure as defined by the Pascal's law of physics. So now I hand it over to Soumya.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon. I am Soumya Patel and my ID number is 20CE035. So today I would like to speak about construction process. So first of all, what is tunnel construction? Tunnel construction is an underground passage provided beneath earth surface or water surface. In olden days, it was considered as a difficult task. But in today's world, due to advancement of technology, modern equipments are discovered and now it has become easier. Mostly, tunnel construction is expensive, but it saves a lot of time and it provides comfort. Tunnels can be used for roadways, railways, and even waterways. In many cities, underground metro rail network work inside a tunnel. Next. There are different types of method developed for construction of tunnel. Today, I will discuss four of them. First, cut and cover method. Next. The cut and cover method is used to drill a shallow depth in the soil. There are two basic cut and cover construction methods, namely top-down method and bottom-up method. Both methods are suitable for station box construction, while tunnel box structure is usually constructed by bottom-up method. First of all, a guide wall is constructed, which is known as D-wall in this method. Then excavated soil is removed from the trench by grab operation and it is loaded in the disposal area or the free area. Excavation is done step by step or panel by panel. As it is shallow depth or more depth is obtained while excavation, reinforcements are inserted into that excavated panel or temporary structural support is provided so that the surface doesn't break down. In certain part, small size excavator are also used to excavate small part of soil. But the disadvantage of this method is that more resources and laborers are required as we have to excavate whole part of the soil. Next. Second, bore tunnel method. In today's world, this method is used very much. Tunnel boring machines is the main machine used in this method. There are different types of tunnel boring machine and they are used as per their requirement. This machine works automatically, so it is feasible, quicker and good method. These machines can be used in difficult conditions such as below the water surface. So to drill below the water surface, a special pressurized compartment is provided for tunnel boring machine to work in below the water condition. First, excavation is done manually by the cut and cover method or drill and blast method to insert the tunnel boring machine inside the soil. And during excavation, outer surface is also plastered so that the surface doesn't break down. The disadvantage of this method is that the tunnel boring machine is much costlier and also much heavier. And the advantage of this method is that it is more useful as it makes more finished tunnel. And the biggest advantage of this method that this method can be used anywhere, like in urban areas, in rural area, or in waterways, or in hill areas. Next. Third method, drill and blast method. In this method, initially, geotechnical surveying is done as to check whether the soil is proper to remove or not. In this method, drilling rigs are used to drill holes on the proposed tunnel surface to a designated depth. Then the ladder will come and insert explosives and timed detonators in the drill holes. After blasting through the vacuum tubes, the particles and the waste or the dust are carried out. And when the oxygen is available, then only the person will be allowed to go into that part and do the further blasting. Once the blasting is carried out, waste and rocks are transported out of the tunnel. These waste, rocks and loose material are removed by small excavators. And the process of removing this loose material is called scaling. Also, after blasting, it is drilled vertically and the concrete is poured in that drilling hole so that the surface doesn't break down. But the disadvantage of this method is that it is very slow process and at a time it can drill about 4 to 5 meters, and in a day on an average it can drill about 14 to 15 meters. So it is a tedious process and it is very slow process. It is mostly carried out in isolated places such as hilly areas or water surfaces, and wherever the blasting is not possible, such like city areas or busy traffic areas, at that place the blasting is not possible because it can cause harm to the people. So at that place the traditional method like cut and cover method or TBM method is used. Next. Fourth, underwater tunnel construction. An underwater tunnel is a structure which is built under the water to make a way through it. In olden days, the people are facing many issues that how to go from one side to other side in the river. So underwater tunnel is a good choice. It is a costly process, but we have a lot of advantage over as we can go from one place to another. Immersed tubes or bored tunnel are the two most common methods which are used to construct underwater tunnels. So this was it by my side, and now the remaining part will be explained by Brijraj.
Hello, sir. Myself, Brijraj Singh Jadeja, and my ID number is 20C029. There are many metro lines are there in Mumbai, like Metro Line 2A, Metro Line 3, Metro Line 4, etc. But today I will discuss about one of the example of metro, which is Mumbai Metro Line 3. First of all, I am talking about the construction of Mumbai Metro Line 3. Actually, Mumbai Metro Line 3 is not open yet. It is under construction. And this metro line is between Colaba and Bandra. All constructors and sub-constructors mostly involved in tunneling work are joint ventures, include L&T, STEC, Dogas, and many other corporations. This Metro Line 3 is 33.5 km long and fully underground line with 27 stations. And this line connects 6 business districts, 30 educational institutes, and as well as international airport terminals. Next. This Mumbai Metro Line 3 is also known as Colaba Bandra SEBS line, and this SEBS meaning Santa Cruz Electronic Expert Processing Zone. It is in Andheri East. And this Metro Line 3 is a first underground metro line in Mumbai. And this line will operated by MMRC, Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation. And the cost of this corridor is estimated 30,000 crore and nearby $4.2 billion. And as shown as figured, the line starts at a curve Parade, and it will be run through Narima Plot, Churchgate, Mahim, Bandra, and Santa Cruz, and it will also passes through international terminals of Mumbai Airport. And this line 3 is expected to reduce road congestions. Next. And this picture is construction of Mumbai Metro Line 3. Next. And this is a video of Metro Line 3's construction. Here we will end up with conclusion. Metro system are superior because they provide much higher carrying capacity and it's compared with the road based systems cause no air pollution and no road space if underground. And also metro system are comfortable and safer than road based systems. Next. And these are the references. Next.
I would like to thank our professor who gave us the opportunity to present ourselves. I would also like to thank you for hearing us patiently. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
After the presentation, you can understand what is TBM, tunnel boring machine, okay, which propagates, not cover, I think, in our syllabus, basic civil engineering, TBM. Okay, so TBM is a tunnel boring machine. And in 2019, before this pandemic, in our BBM college, from the student chapter, we organized an industrial visit and we visited this Colaba metro station. Okay. So we see so the actual process, how the TBM is work, okay, how the water jetting effects is utilized for the tunnel boring, okay, and how they use the tunnel boring machine in the actual field. And the student from the fourth year, okay, like there is a 40 to 50 students are there, and we visited that metro station at the Colaba Junction. Okay, and these are the under construction. So it was a very advanced technique we use for the construction of a metro, especially that TBM, tunnel boring machine. Okay, so these are the advanced construction technique used for the construction in metro. Also, the metro is a newly innovative idea, you can say, we can use. Okay, so overall, the information about to start with the metro and the station and the procedure, how we bore the tunnel and the video. So how we start, what is the TBM machine I use, why I use, and what is the effect on the transportation, the speedy transportation, time saving, why also the carrying capacity, passenger carrying capacity is higher compared to the bus, okay, or BLTS also. Okay, no need extra land acquired for the TBA for a metro because it is underwater or underground. Okay, yes, there is a construction cost is large, or you can say the more compared to the BRTS and the highway transport. But it is future, in a future, you want to faster movement or faster transportation. This is the main mode of transportation like a metro. Okay, so very good. Your presentation is good enough to understand what is the metro and how we use and how we construct a metro. So overall, it was a nice, very nice presentation and very good.
Okay, because thank you so much, sir.
Presentation is also a self-made. Okay, not in a topic or in not any book that all contents are covered. Okay, so you find on internet or Google from the video, YouTube. So it is also self-learning process. And in this presentation, we can see that how the self-learning is important. Okay, because in a books, like there is a basic civil engineering books or any books, we cannot find that all the content. Okay, so the self-learning,
yes, self-improvement,
yes, is also important. Okay, so today we learn a lot of more. Okay, the content on all this, it's okay. But from these 2 days, we learn new things. Okay, how to prepare a presentation, how to explain, how to cover the syllabus, how to grab the opportunities when you have a presentation, when you have good communication skill, to how to present your skill on that platform, it is also important. So these 2 days are very helpful and very learning experience are good from the student aspect. Okay, student also known very new thing, the use of whiteboard and all this. So it was a very nice day from my side and very good presentation. Now we go for the next presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, very nice. Now next group is 23. ID number is 45, 54, 57, 61, and 22.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Who is the presenter?
45, sir.
45. So this is your time.
Hello, sir.
Yes. 45 or 54?
45, sir.
45.
Okay, everyone have a data, enough data to continue after this presentation, or the data is consumed?
No, sir.
Okay, so for today, this is the last presentation. After that, we complete that presentation. The remaining presentation we will cover tomorrow. Okay, because 1, 2, 3, 4, I think 6 or 7 rooms are remaining still. So another one day we can use for the presentation. Also, those who are absent in yesterday's presentation. Okay, so those who are also are able to present their sites. Okay, so this is the last presentation for the day. Yes, hello.
Sir, my screen is visible now?
Yes, screen is visible.
Okay,
we can start the presentation mode. It's very good.
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yes.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Our group number is 23 and myself, Mayank Kanjaria, ID number 20C057. And my group mates are 20C045 Jill Patel, 20C054 Jill Sangani, 20C022 Anand Parwadia, and 20C061 Jyot Patel. And our topic of today's presentation is cement as civil engineering material, and guided by you, that is Professor Parma Jawar, sir. So now we will look at the index. So first of all, introduction and what is cement is going to covered by me, and then Portland cement and function of cement ingredients is covered by 20C045. Then 20C054 will cover characteristic and properties, and then uses and types will done by 20C022. And grades and tests are covered by 20C061. So first of all, I will start by introduction. So introduction of cement as civil engineering material. So as you see in the picture, he is a Joseph Aspin. Cement was first discovered by him in 1824. He called it Portland cement because cement he discovered resembled the limestone was found in Portland. So, cement is very essential binding material in the construction of civil work. So, without the cement, the material in the construction of civil can't do. So there are mainly two types of cement, natural and artificial. So natural cements, which we found from the nature. So it is mainly prepared from limestone by crushing and powdering it, which contains 20 to 40% clay, calcium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, etc. So this cement is brown in color and it set very quickly when mixed with water. And the second is artificial cement, which is man-made, and it is obtained by calcination of in cement mixture of 65% calcium carbonate and 35% clay. So cement is mixed with water to form a paste along with sand, gravel, or crushed rock, which ultimately form a durable mass known as concrete. So concrete is another topic, so we will not see it. We will only continent only on cement. What is cement? The word cement has come from the Roman word opus caementitium. As you see in the figure, it is grayish in the color, so it is an artificial cement. If it's brown in color, then it would be a natural cement. So a cement is a binder, a substance used for construction that sets, hardens, and adheres to other materials to bind them together. So it acts like a fabric which binds two materials together. Cement is seldom used on its own, but rather to bind sand and gravel together. Cement mixed with fine aggregate produces mortar for masonry, or with sand and gravel produces concrete. Thank you, sir. And I would like to invite my another group mate, 20C045, for further discussion. Yes, 20C045, you can continue.
Sorry, sir. I think I moved. Good afternoon, sir. My name is Jill Patel, ID number 20C045. My topic is Portland cement. You can see in the figure that this is a Portland cement. It is also some greenish gray color, so it is artificial cement. It is called man-made cement. Now we will talk about ingredients of Portland cement. So you can see in the table there are 8 ingredients: first lime, second silica, third alumina, 4 iron oxide, 5 magnesia, 6 calcium sulfate, 7 sulfur, 8 alkyls. So you can see the percentage by the weight, third and fourth column. Now we are discussing about the function of cement ingredients. First, lime. Lime is the main ingredient. Excess lime is harmful. Harmful because it is expand this aggregant, retreat the setting properly and makes the cement unsound. If lime is less cement, before poor in strength and set quickly. Second, silica. It is the second most important contributor responsible for the strength of cement. Excess of silica increase the strength of cement, but at the same time the setting time is propagant. Third, alumina. It is combined with water continues to form aluminates that are responsible for cube setting of the cement. It acts as a flux and lower the cleaning temperature. If the excess is weakness, the strength of cement. Fourth, calcium sulfate. It is added to the cement after the burning stage in the form of rock gypsum. It acts as a repeater, that is, it expand the initial setting time of cement. 5. Iron oxide. It is responsible for the color of the cement to some extent. It also impacts the hardness and strength of the cement. 6. Magnesia. When present in small proportional, magnesia is a useful is impacting color and hardness. Excess the magnesia reduces the soundness of cement. 7. Sulfur. A very small amount of sulfur is useful in making cement sound. If it is excess, it makes the cement unsound. 8. Alkalis.
Most of the alkalis in raw material are removed by the fuel gases during heating. If they are in exchange in cement, they result in alkali aggregates reaction and straining when used in concrete, brickworks, or masonry mortar. Now, I would like to invite my friend Jill Sangani, 20CU054, to other information. Thank you.
Hello, sir. My name is Sangani Jill. My ID number is 20CU054. My topic, first topic is characteristics of cement. And here are some points of characteristics of cements. The color of ordinary potlet cement is a greenish gray. The color of cement must be uniform. It should feel smooth when touched or rubbed between the fingers. If you insert your hand in the bag of cement, it should feel cool. Should be free from any hard lumps. It should be mist free, most free. It should not exist silica, lime, alumina, or alkalis. It should not consist excess amount of clay and slate. Next topic is portraits of cement. Here, three types of portraits of cement: physical portraits, mechanical properties, and chemical properties. First one is physical properties. Physical properties depend upon the chemical composition, proper burning, and grading process. First point is fineness of fineness. If the cement is finer in grazing size, its quality is better. It is a belief that in finger grain size, the cement particle react very swiftly in water and reduce the time for hardening. Second point is a soundness. Soundness during setting the cement expands. This expansion is sometimes responsible for cracking of cement after setting. Soundness is the capacity of cement to form a non-descending, a hard and uniformly strong mass of setting. Third point is a setting of cement. The setting of cement is defined as a capacity of cement to resist the loads without disengaging of cracking. The change for from plastic mass to red mass of cement may take time between few minutes to an hour more. Fourth point is a setting time. Some cement set quickly with a few minutes, whereas other may take time between few minutes to few hours. Third property is a mechanical property. There are two mechanical properties of the cement: the compressive strength at the end of 3 days should not be less than 150 kg per semi square, and that at the end of 7 days should not be less than 175 kg per semi square. The tensile strength at the end of 3 days should not be less than 20 kg per semi square, and that at the end of 7 days should not be less than 335 kg per semi square. The third one is a chemical properties. The quality of Portland cement depends upon the ratio of lime, silica, iron, and alumina. Ratio of percentage of lime to percentage of silica, alumina, and iron oxide should not be less than 0.66 and should not be more than 1. A ratio of percentage of alumina to iron oxide should not be less than 0.66. Weight of magnesia should not exist 5%. Weight of insoluble ratio should not exist 1.5%. Total supplier content should not be more than 2.75%. Total loss of ignition soul not exist 4%. Here some more other properties of cements, like it is a excellent building material. It provides strength to the masonry. It possesses good plasticity. It is easily workable. It hardens early if offers good resistance to the moisture. Here my topic is all complete. I like to invite my friend ID number 20C022 to continue next topic.
Hello friends, good afternoon to everyone. My name is Parvati Anand and my ID number is 20C022. I explained about uses of cement and types of cement. Cement is a very useful binding material in construction. The application of cement over various fields in construction have made it a very important civil engineering material. Cement is used for preparing cement mortar, which can be used for masonry work, plaster, pointing, decorative purpose, etc. Cement is used to make concrete, which can be used for laying floors, roofs, beams, columns, lintnes, stays, etc. Cement is used for construction of structures such as dams, bridges, tunnel, marine structure, etc. Cement is used for construction of concrete roads, water tanks, wells, septic tanks, etc. Cement is used to manufacture the precast concrete blocks, pipes, piles, lintnes, fencing posts, etc. Cement is used for construction of foundation, footpath, watertight floors, etc. It is employed for the construction of wells, water tanks, tennis courts, lamp posts, telephone cabins, road, etc. Type of cement. Besides the ordinary potent cement, OPC, a number of other cements are also manufactured by keeping different ratio of raw materials or by adding some additional materials. In addition to ordinary cement, the following are the other important varieties of cement available in the market. Pelum, quick setting cement, rapid hardening cement, high alumina cement, blast furnace cement, low heat cement, white cement, colored cement, sulfate cement, expanding cement, pozzolana cement, hydrophobic cement, waterproofing cement, and acid cement. First, quick setting cement. It is produced by adding small amount of alumina sulfate, Al2SO4-3. It is finally grit. It contains very less or no retarding substance like gypsum. Setting action of this cement start in 5 minutes after additioning water and becomes hard within 30 minutes. This cement is used for underwater construction. It is also used in rainy and cold weather condition because of underwater construction, flow of water is very high. So we are getting work faster and faster. So we get use quick setting cement in case of concrete. Rapid hardening cement. It is also known as high earlier strength cement. It is produced by adjusting the proportion of raw materials. It gives strength within 2-4 days. It is used when the important factor for roads, pavements, and highways construction, RHC is used for early strengthening so roads can be made available for use faster than OPC construction. In cold weather countries like Canada, Iceland, Russia, Norway, etc., RHC is used. High alumina cement was first developed in United Kingdom in 1925 by cement produced by name Laffred. High alumina cement, sometimes known as calcium aluminum cement or aluminum cement. It is produced by fusion of bauxite and limestone. High alumina cement uses the cement is used again corrosive action of seawater. It is used near seashore. It is widely used in marine construction at shore infrastructure. It is also used in refractory concretes where it requires more strength at very high temperature. The most disadvantage of high alumina cement is as the heat required for the manufacturer of this cement is more. The manufacturing cost is of this cement is high. Fourth, blast furnace cement. This cement, the slag obtained from blast furnace is used. It has slow rate of hardening and less rate of hydration. It is affected by seawater, hence it is used in marine structure. It is used in mass concreting works such as dams, foundation, which require low heat hydration. Low heat cement. In this type of cement, the heat of hydration is a very low setting of and hardening. This cement used in construction of dams. It reduces cranks and structure. Low heat cement is a ideal for mass concrete engineering, heavy structure, and high strength concrete engineering, marine engineering, wind turbine plants construction, high rise building foundation construction, underground and underwater works, etc. It is environment friendly. The production of low heat cement has low energy consumption and less harmful gas emission. White cement, it is produced for China clay and white clank in place limestone and clay. It is costly and uses for entire decoration and architecture finish. Colored cement, the pigments like oxide of the lead and used to colored cement. It is used to flooring and decorative purpose of building. Sulfate cement. This cement prepared by adding calcium sulfate and blast furnace slag or in ordinary cement. It is especially used to massive concrete work in seawater. Sulfate resistant cement is type of Portland cement in which the amount of tricalcium aluminate C3A is restored and lower than 5% and lower than 25%, which is reduced in formation of sulfate slates. Sulfate cement uses in foundation, building works, efficient treatment plants, chimney, cooling towers, building near sea coast, suitable for underground works where sulfate is present in soil and water. Expanding cement. It is produced by adding sulfoaluminate and stabilized against. This cement is used for water rating structure. It is also for repairing damaged concrete surface. This cement expands whereas the other cement shrinks. Pozzolana cement. This cement contracts silica in alumina in a reactive form. This cement is mixture of Portland cement and pozzolana. It is used in hydraulic structure such as dams, wear, etc. It is used in pre-stressed and post-tensional concrete members, used in a masonry, mortars, and plastering. Hydraulic cement, hydrophobic cement. It contains admire which discretes wetting ability of cement. It is used in cold and post-forming condition. Hydrophobic cement, also known as hydrographic cement. Hydrophobic cement contains admixture which decreases the wetting ability of cement grains. This cement can be used in construction of water structure such as dams, spillways, and other submergent structure. It can be used in cold weather condition as well as waterproofing cement. In this cement, waterproofing against are added. This cement is leak proof and resistant in chemical attack. Acid resistant cement. It has base on high silicates. It is high resistant to cement. It is used for bending and joining acid proof bricks and tiles. It is also used for lining and joining the vessels of acid storing. Also used in industrial flooring. Our group member, next topic is grades and test is covered by my friend Jyot Patel, 20CE061.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Myself, Patel Jyot, 20CE061. Today, I would like to talk about the various grades. There are three types of basic grades. The first one is 33 grade cement. Second one is 43 grade cement, and the last one is 53 grade cement. if the 28 day strength of cement is less than 33 newton per mm square, it is called 33 grade cement, and it is normally used all reinforced concrete works. If the 28 day strength is not less than 43 newton per mm square, it is called 43 grade cement, and it is used for general construction work. If the 28 day strength is not less than 53 newton per mm square, it is called 53 grade cement, and is used for high rise building, bridge, flyovers, chimney, and etc. There is a one table shown in the PPT. It contains a grade and the compressive strength in newton per mm square in on 3rd day, 7th day, and 28 days. My second topic is taste. First is color. It should be normally greenish gray. Second is feel cool. Thank you. Second one is feel cool. When you insert your hand in bag, it should be feel cool. Third one is absent of hard lump. There should be not be any hard lump in cement. Fourth is the fineness test. Cement should be properly grind. The taste of the fineness is carried out of with saving in the proper mass. Normal consistency test. This test is carried out to determine the quantity of the water to produce a paste of cement. This test is performed with the help of wicket apparatus. Fifth one is interior and the final setting time. When the cement is mixed with the water, paste is formed, which remains for a short period. Gradually, paste change into solid mass. The paste change from the plastic state to solid state. This setting of cement. This test is performed with the wicket apparatus. The last one is the soundness test. This test is performed with the help of the Los Atelier apparatus. Compressive strength test. There is a table shown in the PPT which shows the different mixes ID and the compressive strength of mixes ID at the different temperatures. This is a picture of the tasting lab. It is a special cement tasting lab. There are the different tests performed of tasting labs. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for listening us. Our presentation here over. Thank you.
Thank you, all of you, for listening us.
This grade of the cement.
Thank you, sir.
And what is the strength, the minimum strength is required.
Sorry, sir, your voice is not clear.
Okay. Now? Audible clearly?
Yes, sir. Okay. Go ahead. Yes,
sir. So in this presentation, the grade of the cement, okay, 33, 43, and 53. And the minimum strength is required after 28 days is for 43, 33, and 53 grade. Is that based on that grade is required for the 33 grade? The minimum strength after 28 days is what? 28 days is 33 newtons per mm square. Okay. So, you know for the 53 mm, for the 43 and the 33. And also there is one table which gives you an idea about that after 3 days, the strength of like a 33 gate. So, the 16 newton per mm square after 7 days will be 23 or 25 mm square per square. Okay, so the strength of a various cement based on the grade depend on the grade and also the various tests perform on a cement for checking is the quality and the strength. So various topics is covered. Also the images, you can see the test perform on the cement that is also discussed here. So overall, the presentation is nice to understand the cement and its grade and the various tests perform on the cement. So it will be very good presentation. So very nice.
Overall presentation. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
So now we ended here our day two presentation. Tomorrow I will schedule another meeting for remaining presentation. Okay, and we will start with the group number 24 and then up to the group number 30. And after that, those who are absent in day one and day two, we will conduct their presentation also. Okay, only their, but not whole presentation, but only their portion. Okay, so after the completion of all the presentation, I will give a rank to top three presentation tomorrow. Okay, so at the end of this formality, or this as a memory part, okay, for the online or a virtual classes, please turn on your camera, everyone. Okay, because in this virtual world, you can say virtual online classes, we have a chance to face each other and not chance to meet each other. So this video conference, or you can say the video mode, is help us to see each other and recognize each other. Camera, everyone. What you can also take a screenshot. Hope you like this presentation. Okay, because after all, this presentation is for you, okay, not for me, for purpose. For example, this presentation is conducted for you to improve your skill, like a presentation skill for making a good presentation. Also, it helps you to understand the topic. Okay, this topic after presentation, at least you know better about your topic, so it will help you to understand the topic. Okay.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Okay, so how was your experience in first semester, second semester? I want this general chat regarding